He's steady hollering, raising sand, standing up on that fence. When he sees me climb up in his truck, it's like he ain't got no sense. He's a rebel for the cause, he's one badass hunting dog. Some night he's gonna make us Grand American champions. Briarwater and Kane, that dog's bad. When that bandit hits the ground, he's had.
Alright guys, we're just out here with me, my mom and dad, and Bandit. My brothers didn't come. We're just dropping him at a creek real quick to see how he does. Trying out my new dance that I got for my birthday yesterday. Hopefully they'll work. Go get him, Bandit. Can you see some of my TV from here? Yeah, because he's scratching on that crap. Okay, guys. Well, we've seen two squirrel nests, so maybe the coon was hiding in them. Never know. Get him, Bandit. Get him, boy. Strike him. Started looking at trees around just in case, you know, if the coon jumped. Well, then we seen it right up. I forget which tree. It was one of these trees in here. And it bailed because I couldn't get the gun quick enough to my dad because I'm not a fast shooter. I like to take my time.
Good boy.
water when we get home. Yeah, I think I'd rather end on a good note than a bad note.
Yeah, we're going to see you.
Guess who got him up tonight? Bandit! Well, anyways, the coon was up in the tree, and I tried to give the gun to my dad because I can't aim that fast, but he bailed on him, but I don't care. He still did good by himself. He only had caged coon. He's a pup about 3 or 4 times. Good boy, Bandit.
Good boy, Bandit.
Good boy. Come on. Ready, Bennett? Ready? Load up, Bennett. Load up. I'm so proud of this dog. This is his first official coon by himself. Trade with the meat, boys. Don't fall off, Bennett. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Okay, time to get in. Are you ready to go home? Get some water?
No.
You're going in. He wants some bags for some reason. Get in.
Come on, Bandit. Get in.
His breath stinks.
Bandit, load up.
Come on. Smack him like we do, Mojo. There you go. Good night, Coon Hunting, just Bandit. Isn't that right?
This episode is brought to you by Kelly's K-Light Supply, lighting the way for future generations to come. A family-owned business located in Cleveland, Texas, leading the industry in customer satisfaction and affordability. Lighting your way with Kelly's K-Light.
doing? Hey! Get up on that tree! Come on! Hey, come on! Get up! Come on. Come on.
Alright guys, it's Team Lil'Cooners back here for a tailgate talk. We've been soloing our dogs out because we've heard from multiple old-time coon hunters that will make your dog more independent and a little better on treeing. So we always take the advice anybody gives us. We always give it a try. If it works, it works. If it don't, don't. So that's about all for the night. We didn't treat, so I'm happy. Bojack's tired, boy. He wasn't on his A game tonight, but I'll take a dentry over a slicker opossum any night. That's all I gotta say. What you gotta say, Mojack? Yeah, you ready to hit the bat sack, ain't you, boy?
Alright, guys, it's Team Lil'Cooners back here. We're down in the creek. We recently got to trap. We got permission to trap this year. We did last year. So we're gonna bring in some trapping videos at you for this trapping season. We got our dams, we got our traps, got our bait. Everything, we're set, ready to go. Go find some signs, set some traps. Right over there, we already caught a slide that we might set one on. Not for sure, we're gonna go investigate real quick. This creek is really deep and muddy. Well, it's not deep at first, but once you get in there, it's mud and you just sink. So you gotta be careful. As long as I got our hands, I don't think we're gonna get flooded out.
All right, guys. Well, we're down here on this creek setting some traps and found this slide here. I'm guessing it's probably a muskrat. And it doesn't look like they've used it today because you can see there's some leaves piled up on it. But it definitely looks like they're using it pretty regularly. I can't see any tracks in it, so that means they're sliding down it a lot. So we got this 110 conibear right here. And right now I'm looking for a good spot to set this where I know they're going to hit it, where they're not going to avoid it when they're coming down. So I'm thinking right here when they... Or, I don't know, it's kind of a tricky spot because it's on an angle. Probably right there so they don't avoid it, so it's going right down their trail. So we're going to get this staked up right now. We'll get it all set up good. Hopefully we're going to catch it out in this.
For 110s, all we use for a stake is a stick, because as soon as that hits some muskrats, they're done for. So we've never had a live muskrat in a 110. And I don't know if anybody's ever had a live muskrat in 110. So, want me to go get that ground hold?
Yeah.
Don't stop me from getting into this water. Where is it? It's right in here.
All right, guys, we just made another set over there for muskrat. It's on another trail. It's coming down off the bank, and then there's a big den under it, but the den's too big to get a 110 set on it, and we didn't bring any 220s, so we just set the trail. Hopefully, we either catch a mink or a muskrat. We've caught a mink here, too, before, so. I'm sketched out right now. I don't like this. got bait?
No. Won't have nothing. Just the trap and dirt
is what we're getting right now. There we go. I'm trying to get it out of my way, so.
You need more dirt than that. Just grab a handful.
Pack these jaws down. You got a pan cover, Logan?
No, I told you to grab some.
Oh, they're in that box. I threw them all in there.
Oh, screw it. You already put the jaws down.
All right.
I wouldn't pack that wet mud up underneath the pan.
I didn't pack it under the pan.
It's dry mud under there.
Right there.
That's what I said.
I picked this spot. Aren't I good?
It kind of looks like fox shit.
Oh, really?
It'd be cool to get a fox.
Would we get one in that trap?
Yeah, I'd catch it. It's a bridge of 1.5.
Oh, I think it's crap my pants. You gotta take it out of the video.
Alright, guys.
Alright,
you
what are you doing?
Heck of a job, Momo.
We're back here. We just made a coon set. We're using some homemade bait, Bridger 1.5. Disposable stakes. As you can tell here, we're kind of funneling the coon to step right on my trap, which is right there. The reason we set here is because if you look right back in here, we did. Well, I'm gonna put that back, but right back in here, some coon crap. This one's pretty fresh, actually. It's still moist. So they kind of visit this regularly, it looks like, because there's lots of crap. And yeah, so I hope we get a coon. We got it all blocked off. We figured out they're probably coming from this creek, crossing from over there somewhere. So I think we should get up, let the spot be, and we'll come check them tomorrow.
Get our bait.
Yeah.
What was it, a Duke? Yeah. Looks like something went in there. What?
All right, guys, we're going to take a little break to show you what all we got here. We're going to go through each little setup we have and show you what we got in it. So, first off, we'll come over here to our baits. We got some pan covers and, you know, all kinds of different baits for whatever we're going to trap. So, we got, like, some coyote bait, muskrat, fox, mink. And we got a little appeal for the eye. We made this from the rabbits that we raised and killed. Well, butchered. And the next bucket, we got our traps. They all vary. Like, we got most of them are Bridgers. But we got Bridgers, Dukes, and that's it. They range from coyote-sized traps to muskrat and coon. The next bucket, we got our groundhog. This was probably the best investment we had for trapping. It helps really a lot. And then under this, we got dry dirt. We got the bag over it because we have a light sprinkle and we don't want it to get wet. And then next, we got all our sticks that we strapped. This is what we use for our 110s because kill them pretty quick. We got our gauntlets for water trapping. And then we got our flagging tape so we don't forget our traps.
Yeah.
And then we got a little bag full of old deer meat that somebody gave to us. So let's go get some traps set. And hopefully we come back tomorrow and got some for you guys. Since we put some dry dirt in there, it should work better. get some dirt right here. Yeah. Pack it in there nice and solid. Oh yeah, there we go. Pretty good.
Get that groundhog.
I think I'm out of the regular, whatever it is.
Ooh. I adjust that.
Alright guys, this is our first coyote set we're putting out. We're going to see what happens. We're using a Bridger number 3. Yeah, 3. 4 coil, fully modified. So right now Logan's putting dirt over the top of it. Dry dirt, because this stuff is wet and we don't want it to clog up our traps. So, we'll see what happens.
6, there's 2 right there. 7. We didn't do any down there.
I need rocks.
Right, what kind of rock?
Little rocks.
There's a smaller one. No mind if I'm stuck in the damn ground.
That's the smallest.
I meant like tiny, like pebbles.
Yeah.
Hey.
Then you put your bait down in that hole.
Yep. Cold out here.
Well, I'm gonna have to do that now.
It's not cold enough to see your breath.
Temperature's dropping.
We were looking for like a coon or something. Look at it. Yummy. Oops.
So, in this dirt hole, we used this 3-meat bait. And we used old deer meat and put some fox pee up on these rocks on the backing. And I'm pretty sure that's all we need on this. Got some other lures here, but I don't know. We don't need those. Might use some of this just to get them in.
It doesn't take very much of that stuff either, right there.
That's what that three.
Oh, good. Smell it. I remember, who was it again that was like, I was like, I'll pay you something.
Skyler.
Didn't he do it?
Yeah.
He licked it, didn't he?
Did he really? That's freaking disgusting.
Yeah, he licked it.
Trespassing, what does that mean? Don't Farmer Brown know by now that dog of mine can't read. Posted, somebody tell me what that means. It works like this, I follow the dog don't follow me. Come rain or shine, I'm gonna hunt. If you catch me, I'll be glad to do my time.